Clarizen Profiles are all about usability, security, and flexibility, and allow you to manage and control the way the system is displayed for each user, department, or group in your company. With Profiles, you have the ability to tailor Clarizen for each role in your company and display only the modules, fields, panels, actions, and views that are relevant to team members. This means that you can truly customize Clarizen to ensure a simplified, user-driven workspace based on specific usage of the system. Additionally, Clarizen Profiles allow for improved permission sets by giving you the ability to define user access to fields, actions, and workflows. This allows you to limit certain users and groups from accessing data and triggering workflows that aren't relevant to them. Let's get started by taking a look at how profiles can change the way you work in the system. This user is currently set to the admin profile. This profile gives the user access to all the different modules when accessing the navigation panel, including several different custom Clarizen pages. Selecting the new menu and then request displays the fields and sections relevant for admin users when adding new requests to the system. Now, let's switch the user to the marketing profile by selecting the name dropdown. The profiles section of this menu displays all the different profiles the user has been associated with and allows the user to easily switch between profiles to view and navigate the system according to their needs. To switch between profiles, simply select the relevant profile. In this case, let's select marketing. Accessing the navigation panel, you'll notice a modified list of modules, providing a simplified, user-driven workspace for the marketing user. Now, let's select the Requests module. Clicking on Add Request in the ribbon displays a different ad mode than the one displayed for admins, as it is fully tailored to marketing users who need to add new requests in the system. In fact, the views, fields, relations, and even the ribbon action buttons are fully configured for marketing users, meaning they can quickly and easily view the data that is relevant to them. Let's edit this view to access the sharing options by clicking on the view name and then selecting Edit from the pop-up. You can see that the view owner is set to Helena, who created this view. You can also see that the view can be edited by the marketing profile. Since marketing users have read-write access in this view, it means that they have the ability to set the sharing permissions of the view and can add relevant users, groups, or profiles as editors or viewers. For example, let's say that you want to give the creative group and Frank access to this view. Simply add these two and select their view permissions. In this case, let's go with viewer, since we don't want to give them the ability to edit or modify the view itself. Not only can you share views with specific people, groups, or profiles, you'll also notice that there are special groups so that you can share views with all internal users, financial users, and the like. Now that you know a bit about Clarizen profiles and their benefits, let's take a quick look at how to get started building out your organization's profile set by accessing Settings and selecting the Profile tab. Like all organization-level settings, profiles can only be created and modified by administrative users in your organization. To best utilize profiles, ask yourself how you wish to divide the various display options. This can be done based on a user's role, department, skills, or other needs. Once you've determined the profile mapping, it's time to start implementing them. For starters, let's take a look at the master settings. The master determines the overall definitions of your organization. Changes to the master settings, such as the available modules, field sets, and the like, will affect all other profiles in your organization, and these settings will be used as the base for creating new profiles. To create a new profile, simply click on the plus at the bottom of the profile panel and set the profile name. In this case, let's build a profile for external collaborators. Users with this profile will typically collaborate on tasks and requests and should have limited visibility into fields and other data related to their work. Once the profile has been created, you can determine what modules the associated users will have access to. In this case, We want to limit it to the home, social, tasks, and request modules, meaning everything else can be removed from the navigation panel. Make sure to click Save to implement these changes. Now it's time to assign members to this profile. You can either assign individual users or groups to a profile. Assigning a group will associate all group members with the profile as well. This ensures that if users are either added or removed from a group, the relevant profiles will also be added or removed. Once you've assigned members, it's time to determine the other settings. Since we are focusing on tasks and requests for the external collaborators profile, let's select the task setting. You'll notice that there are several different setting options. For instance, the fields and relations allow you to determine the available fields and related items of a task. If you want to limit users with this profile from viewing certain fields, simply click on Edit and add or remove the relevant fields from the list. The selected fields will be available to users when they access the grid, property card, or build out reports on the selected item type. You can also determine which related items users have access to. This includes Clarizen panels and any other custom relations you have built. Moving over to the Action section, you'll notice that you can select which actions will be available to users in the ribbon, contextual menu, and the bubble pop-up. Let's click on Edit next to Ribbon Actions and remove the actions that are not relevant for the external collaborators. For example, you can remove the entire MISC section or select specific actions, such as to replace resources that just aren't necessary for users with this role. Once you're done, click Save and be sure to go through the contextual menu and bubble pop-up actions as well. The Field Layout section allows you to set up an item's property card and add or edit mode. This allows you to create a simplified, user-driven layout, which ensures users are adding and viewing the data that is relevant to them. The Default Views section allows you to set the default views for the profile, as well as associate different views with the profile. Associating a view simply adds the profile with a viewer permission onto the view itself. Depending on the selected item type, you may see additional settings, such as the search defaults and Gantt columns. To learn more about each of these settings and more about profiles, including the relevant system settings and other configuration options, be sure to check out the Clarizen Help site. To learn more about Clarizen, be sure to check out the other tutorials available in our training center and our Wiki Help site. We also highly recommend signing up for one of our daily live beginner or advanced webinars, where one of our Clarizen experts can answer any of your questions. If you haven't tried out Clarizen yet, be sure to do so with our free 30-day trial. Thanks for your interest in Clarizen. See you back soon.